up guys, it's Aaron here. So I recently picked up the base model of the 2020 Surface Laptop Go to test out for a week and see whether or not it would be a good choice for students like myself or casual users. Now that I've been using this laptop for the past 2 weeks, I can say that I really like the laptop, but as a student, you probably shouldn't get it, or at least the base model that I have here. And today I'll tell you why. If you're new to the channel and like tech or student related content, consider subscribing and turning on notifications for weekly videos. Just to give you guys my thoughts up front, there are a lot of things that I like about this laptop while using it on a daily basis as a student, but I can't justify the price of it for what you're getting. And with so many laptops and tablets on the market for students nowadays, you're probably better off looking somewhere else. But let's talk about some of the things I like and dislike about this device. So starting off with the build quality and overall design, it's an extremely solid laptop and it's also super lightweight, coming in at just over 1 kilogram. You're getting top of the line build quality as you would expect from any Surface device, and its weight also makes it super portable. The materials are all aluminum except for the bottom panel, which is a sort of polycarbonate plastic, but this also doesn't feel cheap and it helps keep the weight of the laptop down. Overall, it feels really similar to the discontinued 12-inch MacBook from Apple, so it's a great size for students who are looking for the full laptop experience, but also want something that's a bit lighter or easier to carry around like a tablet. If we're only looking at the build quality and design side of things, I'm genuinely impressed by how much I like this laptop. It doesn't feel like a budget device at all, and I really like how light and portable it is, while the 12.4-inch display still feels like a full screen display when I'm using it for work or media consumption. Alright, so let's talk about the screen. You get a 12.4-inch PixelSense display with a 1536x1024 resolution, so on paper that's a bit less than full HD. However, in real-world usage, the screen is bright and sharp, and you wouldn't notice that it's slightly less than a full HD display unless you were up really close or specifically looking for it. The more I use this laptop over the last 2 weeks, the more I realize that it's a really good display despite the lower resolution. You have really good contrast, the colors are accurate, and the screen is bright. So you're getting a really good display, especially compared to other mid-tier laptops. I also really like the signature Surface 3:2 aspect ratio on the screen. I think that's a lot better for productivity and functional tasks in school and work, but if you are watching videos on this screen, you'll have the black bars at the top and bottom. The 3:2 aspect ratio paired with the larger 12.4-inch display makes it a lot better than other tablets for multitasking as a student. I find it much more natural to have a note-taking app open beside a lecture video or presentation, and it doesn't feel too crammed on the screen, just like a normal 13 or 14-inch laptop would. The keyboard on this device is another thing that Microsoft did really well with. Although it's a bit smaller than the full-size keyboard on the Surface Laptop 3, it still extends from edge to edge. There's a lot of key travel and it's super comfortable to type with, so you won't be disappointed. However, there is no backlit keyboard, which is a huge downside, especially as a student if you like studying in dimmer environments, it'll be hard to use this laptop in those darker areas. The trackpad is also really good. Again, it's a bit smaller than the one on the Surface Laptop 3, but it's still really responsive and smooth, and all of the gestures work as expected. And obviously you have the option of touchscreen input because it is a Surface device, but keep in mind there's no pen support on this screen, unlike the Surface Laptop 3, but that isn't a huge deal because I don't think anyone is using this laptop to write on. The port selection on the laptop is pretty decent. You get the same as the Surface Laptop 3, so that's USB-A, USB-C, a headphone jack, and of course the Surface connector. The laptop also does charge through both the Surface connector as well as USB-C, so it's nice to have that optionality. The laptop also has no speaker grills, so the sound comes directly out of the keyboard. It's loud enough to get the job done, and I think it works well for watching videos or watching Netflix, but of course it's not ideal if you're using it to listen to music. So let's move on to some things I don't like about this laptop, and the main reason I wouldn't recommend buying it. The specs of this laptop seem to offer mid-tier performance with a 12.4-inch display, 4 GB of RAM, 64 GB of eMMC storage, and a 720p webcam. But after actually using this laptop for the past week, my main takeaway is that the Surface Laptop Go is barely fast enough for a student. It did manage to keep up with my daily workflow as a student, which involves just having a few tabs open in Edge and running some light applications like Microsoft Word or PowerPoint. But even then, it often felt like I was reaching the limits of those 4 GB of RAM. The laptop's fans also came on pretty often, even when I was just using it to surf the web. And the laptop also gets really hot if you run any sort of somewhat intensive application like Photoshop or light gaming after a couple of minutes. So again, the limited specs are already getting bogged down from the relatively light usage I was putting towards it. The 64 gigs of storage also felt immediately restrictive since having Windows installed already took up a big chunk of that space. On top of that, you're also not even getting SSD storage, so if you need to work with any sort of local files, you'll notice that it's significantly slower than what you may be used to. While the laptop is usable today for casual tasks and maybe even for students, it won't be very future-proof, and if you need to do any sort of somewhat intensive work as a student, like edit raw photos or edit 4K videos, this laptop won't be able to handle it. So I'm definitely not satisfied with the performance of this laptop beyond very casual tasks like watching videos or typing documents. But given that I have the base model of this laptop that nobody recommended, I think if you upgrade to the mid-tier model with 8 GB of RAM and at least 128 GB of SSD storage, it would handle a lot of the tasks you need to do as a student much better. And lastly, the battery life of the Surface laptop is also not that impressive despite its weaker performance. After only 3 hours of testing this device on and off, the battery was practically drained, so don't expect any sort of all-day battery life like you would find on the MacBooks or the Surface Laptop 3, which all can easily last over 7 hours of usage. Overall, while there are a lot of things to like about the Surface Laptop Go, and Microsoft did do a good job of bringing the price of a premium feeling device to $550, I don't think the base model of the Surface Laptop Go that I have here is worth it for students or casual users, even if you don't think you'll be doing anything more intensive on this laptop. That's because 8 GB of RAM and SSD storage is practically a necessity in 2021 for Windows laptops. So if you want to pick one of these up, definitely go for the mid-tier model, or better yet, wait until there's a sale so you can pick it up for cheaper than $700. But let me know what you guys think and whether or not you would pick this up as a secondary device, perhaps to complement a more powerful 15-inch laptop or a desktop that you already own. Again, I will say that this is a really fun device to use, and I really enjoy using it around the house to watch Netflix or carry it around with me anywhere, knowing that I'll be able to get some work done. But with that being said, dropping a like if you found this video helpful is really appreciated, and subscribe for more weekly student-related content. But now we're gonna go and return this laptop.
Yeah, I know you see the drip and you like it. Wanna text me but your pride tryna fight it. I know you young chasing love tryna find it. Then I saw you at a party, started with my I want you. So do you want me? If I said I love you, would you love me? I could never dub you, but could you dub me? Yeah, I wanna fall in love, I don't think it's for me. Hope you know I want you, so do you want me? If I said I love you, would you love me? I could never dub you, but could you dub me? Yeah, I wanna fall in love, I don't think it's for me. I ain't no regular nigga. When we pull up to the party, man, the party get bigger. And she fucking with a little techie, cause she know I'm a winner.